carefully. Okay. See how it's saying connecting to the streaming software? Okay, good. It says excellent connection. So when it at 9:45, you can click the go live button up here. So this is already done. You're done with this for right now. Although this is how you can see, you know, obviously what the camera is doing. Yeah. Like that. Okay. So it's telling you can go live now, but I would wait a little while because until they're done, basically, at least. You see your fingers just so there's a slight delay. There was like a 10-second or so delay. See? Okay. All right. Okay, I'm gonna leave this with you now. You wanna go away for a while? It's your choice. Just make sure you're back to me. Okay.
So let's It's fine. It's not. Christ, our Savior.
Amen.
Amen.
Please be seated. I'd like to invite forward one of our parishioners, Joel Waters. He'll introduce himself.
Good morning.
Good morning. Good morning.
My name is Joel Waters, and my wife Julie and I and our four children have been attending St. Andrew's for a little over 1 year. At the end of last year, we chose to pledge to St. Andrew's because of the way people of this parish seek to serve the surrounding community, and because of the way our entire family was so warmly welcomed here. In some ways, we feel a little bit like outsiders, having never attended an Episcopal church before coming here. But the way you all welcomed us in has been a blessing to our family. Many of you told us how you enjoy seeing our younger kids in the family area during the service, instead of asking them to be quiet or less disrupting. The Children and Family Ministry at St. Andrew's has been great for our older kids, and we are thankful for the time and resources that the staff and volunteers here give to that ministry. It has been great watching them learn and wonder about stories of Scripture and begin to learn about the seasons of the church calendar. And it is a very special blessing for us to participate in communion together as a family on Sunday mornings. We also chose to pledge because of the way that the people of St. Andrew's seek to serve the surrounding community. There are so many ministries that this church hosts and supports, so many ways you serve those outside of the walls of this church building. It is great to see a church facility that is used for more than just the entertainment and edification of its members. I want to encourage you as this year comes to a close to prayerfully consider pledging to St. Andrew's and being part of all the things this community is doing here. Thank you.
Happy are they
The Holy Gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ, according to Luke.
Glory to you, Lord Christ.
Jesus entered Jericho and was passing through it. A man was there named Zacchaeus. He was a chief tax collector and was rich. He was trying to see who Jesus was, but on account of the crowd, he could not, because he was short in stature. So he ran ahead and climbed a sycamore tree to see him, because he was going to pass that way. When Jesus came to the place, he looked up and said to him, "Zacchaeus, hurry and come down, for I must stay at your house today." So he hurried down and was happy to welcome him. All who saw it began to grumble and said, "He has gone to be the guest of one who is a sinner." Zacchaeus stood there and said to the Lord, "Look, half of my possessions, Lord, I will give to the poor. And if I have brought in anyone or anything, I will pay back four times as much." Then Jesus said to him, "Today salvation has come to this house, because he too is a son of Abraham. For the Son of Man came to seek out and to save the lost." The Gospel of the Lord.
May the words of my lips and the meditation of my heart be always pleasing to you, our strength and our redeemer. Amen.
Amen.
Please be seated. Well, before I begin my sermon, I want to say a word of thanks to each and every one of you. I was ordained last weekend. And if you've never gone to an ordination, I highly recommend it. It's a mashup between a very meaningful and solemn service and the world's greatest block party. It's a lot of fun. But I would not have been there without your help and your support and your encouragement. So I thank you all very much. The story of Zacchaeus has several themes that we often read in Luke's gospel. Jesus' welcoming of outsiders, the theme of faith and repentance, the right use of money and possessions, and the presence of God's salvation in the world. It also reminds us of last Sunday's gospel reading about the Pharisee and the tax collector, the pride of the Pharisee and the humility of the tax collector. In this morning's reading, Jesus walks into Jericho on his way to Jerusalem, where he will arrive in next week's gospel reading. And here he meets Zacchaeus, the chief tax collector. All tax collectors during this time were assumed to be wealthy, since they had purchased the right to collect taxes and profits above and beyond what the person actually owed the empire. In short, they were extortionists. Luke says that Zacchaeus was rich, and since he was a chief tax collector, he had subordinates who collected taxes, and he took a percentage of them, of their profits as well. Also, Jericho is a major city and a royal city, since Herod had a palace there. So it was a major source of taxation in the empire. Yes, Zacchaeus was certainly a wealthy man. But Luke also says that he was a short man, a man with short stature. Were the people there blocking him because he was a tax collector and resented what he did? Or was he simply not able to see over and around anyone? We don't know the answer. But we do know that he was resourceful enough to climb up a sycamore tree to watch Jesus as he entered the city. Not only does he see Jesus, but Jesus sees him as well. When Jesus sees him, he says, "Zacchaeus, hurry and come down, for I must stay at your house today." We can assume that this was not what Zacchaeus was planning when he climbed that tree. However, Luke says that he climbed down from the tree and was happy to welcome him. In doing this, Jesus manages to violate two rules of etiquette in one statement. He invites himself to someone's home, and the person's home is the hated tax collector. Rather than being repulsed by such a person as Zacchaeus, Jesus is happy to go to his home. It's important to understand that according to the culture of the time, joining someone at their home did not just mean fellowship. It meant that you were both equals and accepted one another. No wonder the Pharisees were stunned when they saw this. By joining with Zacchaeus, Jesus seemed to be approving of him. And by welcoming Jesus into his home, he was about to be transformed. A common theme in Luke's gospel is that of repentance, and that it requires more than faith alone. It needs to be followed by action, and we see this in this morning's reading. A person's life has to reflect their own confession. Zacchaeus does just that when he says to Jesus, "Look, half of my possessions I will give to the poor. And if I have defrauded anyone of anything, I will pay back four times as much." Well, the proud Pharisee in last Sunday's gospel reading reminds God of his faithful tithing. Zacchaeus offers half of his great wealth to the poor. And in reference to the book of Exodus, he also offers restitution to those he has cheated and repents for his past actions. In doing so, Zacchaeus becomes a model of repentance and reconciliation with God instead of a model of greed and avarice. There's much to take away from the story of Jesus and Zacchaeus. One is the story of great wealth and the trappings that go with it. As I've said, the last time I stood here at this lectern, it's not the acquisition of wealth that is the issue. It is the idealization of wealth and what we do with it that becomes the issue. Another is the story, and another common theme in Luke's gospel, that nobody, and I repeat, nobody, is beyond redemption. We can all be forgiven. And we can all be redeemed if we are willing to repent. As I've said here before, the word repentance literally means to turn around, to change our direction and our path from one of sin and sadness to one of faith and joy. As Jesus said of Zacchaeus, which could also apply to everybody assembled here, as well as everybody outside that door, "For he or she, too, is a son or daughter of Abraham. to
Almighty Creator, to whom our needs are known before we ask, help us to ask only what accords with your will, and those good things which we dare not or in our blindness cannot ask. Grant us for the sake of Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen.
Amen.
Turn to page 56 in your booklet. Let us confess our sins to God. God of all mercy,
we confess that we have sinned against you, opposing your will in our lives. We have denied your goodness in each other, in ourselves, and in the world you have created. We repent of the evil that enslaves us, the evil we have done, and the evil done on our behalf. Forgive, restore, and strengthen us through our Savior Jesus Christ, that we may abide in your love and serve only your will. Amen.
Almighty God, have mercy on you, forgive you all your sins through the grace of Jesus Christ, strengthen you in all goodness, and by the power of the Holy Spirit, keep you in eternal life.
Amen.
Peace of Christ be always with you.
And also with you. If you missed Heather's talk on earth-based spirituality, I'll give you a little insight. Some people, like Heather, enjoy feeling more grounded and connected to the earth. So if you wonder, why is she barefoot? That's why. She's on holy ground. Not all of us take our shoes off, but we all know we are on holy ground. Gratitude parties are up and happening. Yesterday we had about 20 of us out here on the courtyard, and we put together socks and underwear and shoes for the Showers of Blessings folks. And we stayed for 2 hours. We stood and chatted. So I hope you'll join us either Tuesday or Saturday. You can RSVP online. Any birthdays or anniversaries that we're celebrating this week, please come forward if you want a blessing on your birthday or your anniversary. Okay. Walk in love let us with gladness present the oblations of our life and labor to God.
Thank you. happened to me when I was bringing them out here. I thought, I'd love this. And all of a sudden,
you did.
Do you want these other ones?